is a Hashim.
Hi Sam, how are you?
Yes.
And thank you. Pleasure to be commentating with you today, Sharon.
Yeah, are we going?
How are you doing, Rosli? Rosli.
Yeah, I think they stopped the competition after we won it.
Assalamualaikum, salam sejahtera, terima kasih kepada Ayat Ros dan Ros bersama kami pasti di Esso Arena sahuran
801-802. Kita
bersiaran secara langsung dari Sports Arena untuk aksi di sebelah petang
dah selesai, di sebelah malam pula bagi saingan
Purple League musim 2013-2018 dan Puchong United akan berpada dengan Ceras melawan yang akan berlakukan secara langsung pada sebelah petang tadi.
Setelah berlangsung
perlawanan sebelum ini, namun yang menjadi perhatian adalah bagaimana tugasan yang bakal dipikul oleh pasukan Ceras. Kerana mereka berkedudukan di tangga yang ke-6 dari 8 pasukan yang ambil bahagian. Dan Puchong United masih lagi kekal satu-satunya pasukan yang belum tewas setakat ini selepas 5 perlawanan. Dan mereka akan turun dalam perlawanan yang ke-6.
Puchong United
dan juga
Kepong. But I think Kepong is going to try to do their very best today against Puchong United. But whatever it is, Puchong will be against Ceras later. But we look at their performance before this. I think both of them
Wong Kyu Hui
has done really well.
Yang menyaksikan pertembungan ini berakhir dengan kemenangan memihak kepada pasukan Puchong.
So what do you think, Sam?
14-3
an exceptional 14-3 victory Puchong United over Serdang BC. It was a thumping in every sense of that word. Of course, that last man single, we saw the impressive way and demolish Leong Jun Hao.
Sementara
and Ceras, I think they are doing their really best this season. Last season, they didn't take part, but obviously this season they are doing their very best. And looks like Rizal as team manager
pasangan,
would have very good advice to their players.
Logan berpasangan dengan
he must have Kowei. Because Ceras BC has destroyed the defending champion PJBC 12-5.
Buat Ceras walaupun
and absolutely we are going to watch whether Puchong United is going
to continue
their great run in Purple League.
Untuk
they have already won 5 matches so far.
Dengan pasukan Ceras BC
obviously has to work very hard.
Letakkan
Chong Yuhan 147
selaku pemain pertama yang akan digolkan yang akan menggalas tanggungjawab.
Grace Chua 96
akan berdepan
Danny Bawa Chris Nanta
dan
Barisan pemain-pemain
pasukan Trust BC. Song Yi Han berada di kedudukan ranking
144
di dunia. Grace Chua Hui Jiang. Dan Hao Ba. Di bawah Krista Nanta. Yi akan turun bergantian dengan Yong Kai. Dalam acara bergulat campuran sementara Fikri Ihsanadi Hatmani.
Fikri Ihsanadi Hatmani
139 ranking in the world. So looks like their lineup are pretty good, Sam.
It's an impressive lineup. This is more or less the same lineup that took down the defending champions, PJ 12-5.
Nova Armada and Azri Hane.
Dijangka.
Sharon, it must be said
what
that
Nova Armada and Azri Hane.
But Pujung United have been in tough form, and I really think that Churras may be struggling today against a much better opponent.
Yeah, but with coach Rashid Sidi, I think you know, it will do good to Churras BC. And Rizal Hussein himself, very inspiring man.
All right, that should be the pairs behind Pujung United tonight in the men's singles category. Give it up for Liu Dara.
Pujung United pastinya
how about Pujung United, Liu Darren, former national
turun
player.
Turun cabaran Pujung United untuk mengekalkan rekod tanpa kalah mereka.
In the women's singles category, Pujung United is represented by Dan Chuan.
So good on court, 88 in the world.
Seterusnya dari acara persorangan.
A player from China, first time.
Dan Chuan.
Pujung United, and actually I think see some skills from Dan Chuan.
Ong Yushin
Cho Yi, absolutely one of our best men's doubles partners. And they've been chosen to play for Malaysia
for Pujung
United in the men's doubles. Lee Hyo Jung and Tan Tian Meng.
Tan Tian Meng dan juga Lee Hyo Jung.
Lee Hyo Jung,
Malaysia dan juga Korea Selatan.
Olympic champion, world champion, together with Lee Yong Dae.
Walaupun kalau kita kemas,
a lot of fans. Here would like to see what she can show to us. Partnering Tan Kian Meng and Wei Nan, our senior from Hong Kong.
Pujung United is coached
by Li Yan Sheng.
Wei Nan.
Li Yan Sheng,
coach for Pujung United BC.
And team manager, Irina Inozemtseva. And she herself, a badminton player from Russia, has been around for a few seasons already, Sam. So look at the lineup today. What do you think?
Okay, Pujung United has absolutely been business here today. It was just seconds away from looking at the team lineup, and I really think that Pujung will be the hot favourite here.
I have in mind after Mocha lost and
less than 12 points in any single competition.
Absolutely, I've just spoken to Irina before this, and she said they will work very hard, very humble of her. She said the lineup is pretty strong today with Liu Darren, Ong Yushin, Chuking, and
ultimately Pujung United.
The Olympic champion Lee Hyo Jung.
Inilah susun atur
partnering Tan Kian Meng.
Pelawanan yang akan berlangsung pada malam ini.
Liu Darren, so far, he has been in the lineup.
Yang saya nantikan adalah dalam acara bergulu
lelaki. So far, so good for him.
Ong Yushin,
Maybe, you know, has no problem with this Chong Yihan, but Chong Yihan again, a young player, Roslin, very inspiring.
Kita terus saja bersama dengan Dayang terlebih dahulu untuk mengikuti rancangan dari kedua pasukan.
Hey guys, okay, so tonight it's Churras versus Pujung United, a very exciting night indeed. With me, we have the two team managers from Churras and also Pujung United. I have a lot of interesting questions I want to ask them before tonight's tie. So as we all know, Pujung United is on top. But getting to the top, as a lot of people would say, is much easier than defending your spot at the top. So what can you say about that for tonight's tie?
Well, to us, we don't much look at the ranking table. It's important that every match is important, and Churras, well known as a very strong opponent. We are fighting for many years against them and always back to back. So to us, it's not about the ranking points, I think, anymore. It's about the performance on the court.
Okay, so for Cheras, on the other hand, we know that Chong Yihan had his first win recently. So how do you think he will keep up this winning momentum for tonight?
He's got a tough opponent, but I think it's a platform for him to prove himself. So hopefully we should be able to have a little bit of an upset.
Okay, and for Deng Xuan, she will be appearing in the women's singles category tonight. And based on history, we know that she nearly took on the world champion previously in the last season. So do you expect her to deliver a 3-0 tonight, perhaps?
Well, it's the first game for Deng Xuan. We want to test all the players, especially we know all that Deng Xuan is very good for 11 points game. So, but it's the first game, she has to overcome the coaches and get used to the environment. But I think she will be all right and can deliver the result for us tonight.
Yeah, definitely. She's going to give quite an interesting battle tonight for Cheras. Okay, so as everybody knows as well, Cheras has three coaches that you always bring up with the players. So with their experience, and we know that they're experts in badminton, do you think this is enough for the players that have been coached by such amazing coaches to go against such a strong team like Puchong United?
Well, the coaches have been with me for quite a while, I think for the past 3-4 years. But having only such a short time with the players, it'd be a bit tough. And making it more worse, you're playing with the top of the league now. So, but, you know, we really hope that we can at least get some points this time.
Well, it's the Purple League. Anything can happen. Let's shake hands to show good sportsmanship. Good luck, guys. And we will go back to our commentators.
Yeah, absolutely. We are looking forward for a good match. Liu Darren against Chong Yihan.
Baik, beberapa pemain muka baru ini baru masuk.
Playing his sixth match, very experienced on court. And absolutely for Yihan. So far, I think
ladies
his performance are pretty good.
The
yang pertama,
just that I think it's all about confidence.
Indeed, and it's an upward trajectory. Chong Yihan having won his first victory against Go Gyap Chin in the last match day number four. But he's up against Liu Darren, Sharon, who is unbeaten in the season. Some Sanheng Purple League. Played 5-1-3 and drew 2.
Mempunyai pandangan tersendiri membabitkan pertemuan.
Chong Yihan, 23 years old.
Kerana berdasarkan
just like what Sam said, so far three matches.
Beberapa kali yang mungkin akan berlaku. Bukan timnas yang mudah saya katakan untuk Liu Darren, Roslin.
Lost two first matches.
Yeah, itulah seperti yang dikatakan oleh pengurus pasukan Cheras BC.
But it's a brand new day. It's a new year, 2018. And I think every players, every club are looking forward for a great year, great start of 2018 for their clubs.
Yang digunakan hanya
11
Darren, mata.
I think,
saya juga mengharapkan
Chong
Yihan dan juga Liu Darren memberikan persembahan yang terbaik mereka pada malam.
Kita nak nampak juga attacking minded dari kedua pemain akan berlaku ataupun sebaliknya menantikan peringkat awal.
Saya menjangkakan mungkin permulaannya agak perlahan oleh kedua-dua pemain ini.
Chong Yihan, pemain kelahiran Melaka, lahir pada 11 April 1994 untuk rekod dalam Purple League setakat ini. Menang dua kali, tewas sekali. Liu Darren, kas juara muka Perancis ketika dahulu. Pernah berada dalam kedudukan 10 pemain terbaik dunia.
Best of 5 system, 11 points.
Dah berusia 30 tahun. Setakat ini dalam kempen Purple League, tidak sekali pun Puchong tidak menurunkan Liu Darren. Ini perlawanan yang ke-6. Setakat ini menang 3 kali, 2 kali seri.
And so far, I think he has been doing well.
Liu Darren ni kadang-kadang ikut mood
really
juga
well.
Ada hari dia datang main attack, dia attack all the way.
I'm sure Yihan, 23 years old from
Yihan
Melaka,
antara pemain yang sedang meningkat naik,
would continue his positive momentum on court.
Best juga kedua-duanya sudah memahami corak permainan masing-masing, walaupun Liu Darren lebih senior daripada Yihan.
Somehow it gives him extra confidence on court.
Apakah tugasan mudah
Empire Nur Juhaida Muhammad Azhar.
Juhaida Muhammad Azhar, selaku Empire Pelawanan.
They have all worked really hard to make this season. And few other seasons to believe a reality and a success.
Pada itu sementara menantikan pelawanan yang berguna kepada anda, peminat-peminat sukan tanah air.
It clubs for this season. And congrats to Cheras BC.
Awal tahun yang sibuk bagi kami di SO Arena selain daripada badminton Purple League.
After, you know, we missed them last season, they came back to compete and I think we're looking forward for them to do well today.
Dan sidang sukan akan memulakan siaran pada 15 Januari jam 10 malam pada Isnin.
Yeah, they do need to put in a lot of effort and I'm glad that I have asked the team manager about the coaching lineup they had. I think that is the secret of Cheras' success against Petaling Jaya BC in the last time out. It was the tactical play of the coaches, of the instructions of the coaches that really, in my mind, switched the game around for Cheras BC against PJ. They very well stand a good chance of doing that today, but I have to still say they are approaching this tie as an underdog for Cheras BC, and particularly Chong Yi Han and his first man singles.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Puchong United BC, represented by Liu Darren, and on my left, Cheras BC, represented by Chong Yi Han.
Januari, tengah malam.
Siapakah pilihan anda?
Anda boleh mengundi.
Jadi
tumpuan semula ke gelanggang untuk pertemuan. Chong Yin Han depan kamera. Depan
what a start. Well, you get nervous.
Mata semangat.
That's fine.
Untuk Lidar.
Well, this must start 2018.
After a few days rest, I guess the momentum, also the feeling. They need some time to get back on court. I think we are looking forward for that. Good match from both of them. That's a very simple smash. I think it's good enough. I think there are times that players don't really have to attack with so much power, but placing and also tactical placement plays a very important part. What do you think, Sam?
I certainly think so, but in that time I just felt that Chong Yi Han was slightly rusty.
You're
absolutely right, it's all about not just the power, but the placement of it as well, where the position and the disguise that goes along with it.
That's a powerful line, right? Open area on the right.
There's only case in point about the placement there. Found the empty space, Liu Darren, and punched the shuttle in.
Perlu dielakkan oleh Yihan. Turut mata disumbut oleh Liu Darren. Tolakkan ke belakang.
Kayes has only 30 minutes maximum.
Bagian Posera.
Pass to Liu Darren. It goes pretty quickly.
Untuk Liu Darren terus mengorak langkah memungut mata yang kelima.
A little bit more because so far he can't predict what's the next shot from Liu Darren.
Memulakan serangan.
Liu Darren has already placed it twice into the forehand side of Yihan. He needs to watch out.
6-2. Secara drive yang tidak lah saya katakan kerap, tetapi kadang-kadang akan berkisar di bahagian depan jaring, Alin.
Ya, betul. Itulah yang cuba dilakukan oleh Yihan.
Ini yang terbaik setakat ini.
Indeed, much more positive.
Mata yang ketiga dengan over smash dilakukan oleh Yihan.
Really loose shot with the lift from Liu Darren and secara tiba-tiba. Punished it.
Ah, Oh, what a great placement from Lidan. Very relaxed, and he knows what's going on, and yeah, that's a point for him.
Sublime and so delicate. Took the pace out of that smash.
He missed that.
Serangan terus ke arah Lidara dan lakukan Lian. Tempo permainan yang saya katakan masih lagi dalam kedudukan berhati-hati. Mata yang diraih oleh Lidara berpunca dari kesempatan belakang gerakan sebegini rupa.
Ya, 3 unforced errors from Lian and 2 service fault. Needs to be a bit more focused, actually much more focused.
So,
give a good fight to Liu Daren, who are now very comfortable at 9-5.
Game point. Pas dari Lidara.
This is a game
di belakang kemudian
he tends to go into complacency mode once he reaches the 10th point and Chong Yihan can very well fight his way back, Sharon.
Tekanan awal dilakukan memberikan mata yang ke-6.
I think that's not too far from getting 10 points.
And also the talking point is really how Chong Yihan is getting this. In mind, Liu Daren has stopped attacking altogether. Need to put in a little bit more pressure on Chong Yihan if he's going to cross over this finish line.
Satu mata saja lagi diperlukan oleh Liu Daren. Sambil lawan terus melakukan tekanan.
So just like you said, Sam, when you stop attacking, this is when Yihan make a comeback confidently.
The last match that Liu Daren played was in the point that led up to the 10-6 lead.
Oh,
11-8. Oh, not yet. Let's see one more time.
Oh, that's landed well in by Chong Yihan.
Returned
the favor to Liu Daren. What Liu Daren did earlier, took the power off the smash.
That's an absolutely brilliant shot from Yihan.
Lakukan oleh Liu Daren ataupun Yihan.
Alam.
Well, we did predict this would happen. He's gone into complacency mode, but
he suspects
Liu Daren will get this point.
You are so right. 11-10. After leading quite far, I guess, in this point system, you can't really relax. And, well, I'm sure Liu Daren is happy to win the first one, 11-10, although at the end, he has to work a little bit harder. Overall, what do you think, Sam, the start of first game?
Well, I just felt that Liu Daren was in cruise control right from the get-go, Sharon, and one of the reasons he was in cruise control was the rear court winners. There were three rear court winners for Liu Daren in that first game alone. Many smash winners as well into the empty space. But what I felt is when he reached that 10-point mark, he stopped attacking. And when they were back level at 10-0, he inserted the pressure. As we look here, we see that the three dots on the right-hand side of the bottom of your screen indicates the three smashes Liu Daren played there, but the rest of it was a series of unforced errors from Chong Yihan, six of them.
Saya rasa dalam kedudukan pertengahan saingan, Yihan sudah tahu membaca pergerakan ataupun corak permainan ditampilkan oleh Liu Daren. Sambil ketika inilah Liu Daren masih dalam kedudukan ataupun kondisi
the best world ranking for Liu Daren in 2013, number 10 in the world.
Nombor 8 minit dengan 11.10 untuk Lidara.
Gone a long way.
Kita beralih ke saingan set yang kedua.
Serisova, one love.
2012, of course, Liu Daren as well won the French Open Super Series, defeating current world number one Victor Axelsen in that final.
Wah, cuba mencari sebelah kiri gelanggang Liu Daren.
Well, it certainly isn't the same Liu Daren we are seeing here, but those are sometimes glimpses of that. That tend to appear once in every now and again.
And really, it's not the same Victor Axelsen anymore. He's the world number one Super Series champion, and many more.
Serisova, 2-1.
Liu Daren pernah satu ketika dahulu dikatakan antara
Chong Yihan now has crept ahead.
Yang boleh dianggap pengganti berada di belakang Dato' Lee Chong Wei. Tapi selepas itu kemerosotan demi kemerosotan.
That's a fantastic one.
Quick,
fast, furious from Liu Daren.
Well, there's only going to be two ways Liu Daren scores. Point one is of the unforced error of Chong Yihan, and the other is through a smash.
Sama.
Wow. What a quick reflection. I think this comes with experience.
Also, one of the things is that Chong Yihan is attacking while the shuttle is behind him, so that means he's moving back momentum-wise, unable to recover quickly enough.
Balikan pukulan itu. Kali lagi serangan.
I think that's the best strategy for Liu Daren. I think so far with attacking shot, that's what got him lots of points. And Yihan absolutely has to improve on the defense.
Mudah dibaca oleh
and at least push the ball away from Liu Daren.
There's a lot of ferocity in the smash of Liu Daren. Suddenly doesn't like the call. As you can see here, he was attacking all along and just played one loose shot and Chong Yihan made him pay.
Base game ni awal ni masih lagi dalam kedudukan biasa-biasa je ni.
Masih biasa.
Tak ada yang nampak secara agresif untuk attack ataupun bertahan yang solid sebenarnya dari kedua pemain.
That's a nice
dari Daren.
Cross court smash. Right at the side of the line. 5-3.
Well, the right hand side of Chong Yihan is
very vulnerable.
It's time and time again repeatedly punished by Liu Daren.
Liu Daren yang kaya dengan pengalaman. Selain kedudukan pemain ini di depan dengan 5-3.
This is the fourth season of Purple League.
Persaingan di set yang pertama.
8 clubs.
Dia mendahului dengan begitu kukuh tetapi selepas itu.
This is Purple League finals will be from 8 of February to 11 of February in Arena of Stars Resort.
Serisova.
Awal.
Bergerak
ke hadapan.
So 6 teams will be fighting to qualify for the finals.
Well, indeed, Sharon, and since you mentioned that, I should mention as well that if Charas get 8 points to
save,
mathematically speaking, into round two, phase two of the Samsung Senheng Purple League. And as for Puchong, they need 8 points. They need 12 points to confirm that they will top the table, heading into phase two of the Samsung Senheng Purple League.
Lepas mainan di jaring. Jaring telas.
Unforced error from Liu Daren. Somehow gives more confidence to Ihan, who are a little bit more comfortable in the second game.
Itu mudah.
Half court.
Dua return tanggung yang diberikan.
The third time of asking.
Ketiga, Liu Darren mengalihkan.
Fortunate in the end, a rather loose return. Well picked off by Liu Darren.
Sebelah kanan, Ihan. Untuk memberikan kedudukan 7-6. Lagi peluang berpunca
nice
daripada posisi
receiving.
Yang tidak sempurna dari Ihan. Lin.
Really, absolutely good smash from Ihan.
Just finding it rather strange that once again Ihan moved to the left of the court. Almost every smash winner by Liu Darren has come on the right hand side. Needs to be more aware tactically. 23-year-old.
Oh, that's a great one.
Dia pula dihukum.
I'm very sure Ihan, although he has lost two matches and he won the previous one against Gyapchin, he has pretty good smash and sense of strategy as well when given the chance.
Indeed, he's one of those players who's able to attack from any angle. Chong Ihan, very fast. I think Liu Darren is struggling with his pace at the moment.
But looking at the unforced error, 7 from Liu Darren and
6
from Ihan.
Hati-hati dilakukan oleh Ihan untuk berikan kedudukan 9.
It's in.
Dalam kali ini.
Sumisoma, 8, Ihan is slowly coming back and getting good points from Liu Darren.
Terjadi.
So just like you said, Liu Darren has to be on the toes absolutely every single time.
Dari angka 6, Ihan mengejar.
Yeah, the longer the rally progresses, the more vulnerable that Liu Darren becomes. If he's not attacking, he is indeed looking vulnerable.
Game point 9.
Ihan, he had this game in the bag, Liu Darren.
Apa yang bermain di fikirannya Liu Darren pada ketika cross smash itu dibuat. Masih servis dari Ihan sebentar tadi. 10-9.
That's a good tap. Very comfy at the front.
Game point. Oh. Berada di game point.
Well, we are treated to a double game point situation. Once again, the replay will demonstrate that how deadly Liu Darren can be when he's on the attack, hunting the shots in the net and pouncing on everything that gets lifted to the back.
Sama. Mungkin anda tertanya-tanya. Undang-undang. Undang-undang dalam perlawanan ini. Setiap perlawanan mestilah ditamatkan dalam tempoh masa 30 minit. Jika keputusan itu berakhir dengan seri, ia akan ke seri.
Oh, unfortunately. A really good strategy, but it's out. So, Ihan.
Untuk memberikan kedudukan meningkat satu sama menerusi.
This is definitely going to rattle Liu Darren and surge of confidence from Chong Ihan as he wins that.
Untuk Nova dan juga Rashid.
11-10, 11-10, and they are both in 8 minutes each. And Rashid Siddiq, absolutely
so
idol in men's singles, giving some advice
seimbang
to
Ihan. Di kedua.
But overall, I think Ihan did some really good changes, improvement in second game.
Akan bermula pada pemulaan di bahagian depan.
And I think that confidence in him is what's really making the difference for Chong Yi-Han.
Remember,
he was looking psychologically down and out in the first game. Coming back to 10-all must have boosted his confidence. And I think this time he was able to do one better than the previous game, and that's to get the 11 point.
Yang banyak kita dapat lihat mereka lebih banyak bermain di bahagian jaring.
For Puchong United, they try to win their 6 matches. For Cheras BC, there's nothing to lose, imbang. But to give their very best to this match.
Permainan yang ditunjukkan oleh kedua pemain ini di game
third game
kedua sebentar tadi.
Level play.
Pula set yang ketiga.
Dari Chong Yi-Han untuk
memberikan
tekanan kepada Lideren di penjuru gelanggang.
Once again, Lideren needs to notice
telah nampak tanda-tanda kedua pemain mau memulakan pergerakan secara agresif. Rosi serangan dan juga pukulan-pukulan smash.
Well, so I guess both of them have tried to push the shuttle to the back and initiate a rally, a longer rally. But it's just that they're not accurate so far.
I suspect the drift has just come back into court. Had some players earlier today saying that the drift was far less today than it was in the previous match days, but yeah, this, I suspect the drift has come into play.
That's a great smash. Again, Lideren using his aggressive smash. Win important points. And if he could consistently do that. I don't think Yi-Han could handle his smashes. But so far, first two games, Darren's focus are a little bit inconsistent.
Yeah, he's been inconsistent, that's just half his problem. The other half is he's not very persistent at what he's doing. He tends to cool off very quickly.
What a great smash, I think. An opener on the right side of Lideren. Yi-Han could see much earlier, and that's when he did best.
Yeah, they're both equal in terms of the rear court winners, Chong Yi-Han and Lideren. The front court winners, Darren, still in front.
Jauh.
Three,
Sasa keluar
two.
Dari Lideren.
This is one of the best rallies so far. Straight ahead to Lideren's body.
You can see the rally was wearing Lideren down. He was in front of the shuttle for the most part in the early of that part of that rally, but towards the end, you can see he's just reacting to the shuttle.
Bolanya seterusnya sentiasa memberi tekanan kepada Lideren.
Kepada anda yang baru saja bersama kami, terima kasih diucapkan secara langsung.
Right to be upset with himself. Chong Yi-Han, this is his third service fault of the match.
Banjir yang melanda di kebanyakan kawasan di sekitar Kuantan umpamanya. Oh, kali ini kesalahan sendiri.
This is what you get from Lideren, who are always ready.
The serve of Lideren cut the top of the tape, and from then on, one thing led to another.
Sesedap rasa saya katakan pada kedudukan dan posisi Lideren.
Lideren is surprisingly slowing down the rallies now. He's not trying to match Chong Yi-Han's pace, but rather trying to drag him down in terms of speed.
He's trying his best. Absolutely, he's trying to move Lideren around, but it's just that the feeling to the front court play, I just not there.
Sorak permainan.
Indeed, and I think that this is really a tactical battle that Liu Darren is winning now, in spite of making more unforced errors. What Liu Darren is actually doing is he is realizing that Chong Yihan is very quick with the fast shot. He's slowing down the rally, which means that Chong Yihan has to wait while the shuttle drops. And that's why the errors are coming from Chong Yihan. It's a tactical game being executed by Liu Darren.
Empat. Selepas kedudukan terikat satu sama, mereka berada di set yang ketiga.
It's a little bit too hard from Liu Darren.
5-6.
Just overhit that last shot.
Banyak perbezaan mata dari ketiga-tiga set.
The intent of slowing down the rally is very obvious.
Pada Liu Darren. Setiap servis dilakukan.
6.
Look at that. Yihan given good chance like that. He'll just finish it, and he's fast.
Hari ini
and he knows
Yihan
that attack to the Liu Darren's body.
Cerita sejarah tersendiri kerana ini pelawanan yang keenam bagi Liu Darren. Dia masih lagi belum tewas.
Not too much space to do anything special.
Sayang pada tindakan yang baik sebenarnya smash itu dilakukan.
This man's downfall from Yihan.
Yang dimaukan adalah melepasi jaring. Masuk ke kawasan lawan.
Very disappointed with himself.
Tapi ianya diakhiri dengan sangkut di jaring. Dua atau tiga kali pergerakan dari Yihan yang menyumbang kepada.
Oh, that's a quick one. That's a big effort from Yihan. Trying to somehow fly to get to the shuttle as soon as possible.
That's exactly what Chong Yihan can do once he injects pace into the game. You notice when the shuttle is flying a lot flatter, those are the points that Chong Yihan is able to pick off and quickly win.
That's an open opportunity for Yihan. And once again, he's quite disappointed.
Errors are seeing Liu Darren, from was once upon a time behind in this game, now creeping ahead by 1 point.
That's fantastic. What a sharp smash from Yihan.
He's been targeting the body of Liu Darren.
Unforced error.
He doesn't have the energy to sustain the attack anymore. Liu Darren. Softer shots instead.
9-8. Lepas dari Liu Darren.
Game point 8.
Untuk memberikan game point kepada Yihan.
Happened to Liu Darren because he was controlling the game.
Telah beraksi hampir 8 minit ketiga-tiga.
Middle part of the game was to slow it down.
Set ketiga ini memasuki 8 minit.
Really no energy to attack.
Tak lepas untuk
last 3 points. With unsuccessful play from Liu Darren.
Lagi 5 minit.
So I guess
keputusan yang akan diletakkan oleh kedua pemain ini.
Starting from the second game.
Jangan banyak buat mistake senang. Tadi tu gampang kali kamu buang ya. Sebenarnya kalau kamu follow ya, tapi tetap cepat mainnya. Jangan ikut main dia. Pasti kamu kena.
Jangan ikut mainnya.
It's quite interesting that Coach Noah Ada pointed out that Liu Darren is changing the tempo and he says in the lane not to follow his pace, meaning that he's telling his charge to increase the tempo because when the tempo increases, he's putting so little on the attack. As for Liu Darren, it's been worn out also, it seems, as we look at this shot chart, 8. The last 11 points for Chong Yihan have come courtesy of an unforced error from Liu Darren.
Di bahagian hadapan saja, seolah-olah ada keyakinan ditampilkan oleh Yihan. Dia lebih confident untuk bermain di bahagian jaring.
tapi agak sedikit mengecewakan apabila tolakan mudah ke belakang dilakukan oleh leader.
Play.
Berarti kata lain Unforcer. Bola set yang keempat. Jangka.
Well, there are a little bit of changes from Ludarin strategy, a little bit faster in the first rally, although it's out.
Keduanya mau pantas segera meninggalkan lawan.
His coach Li Yancheng somehow.
Indeed, and I suspect that Liu Darren is going to throw in the everything he has in the first half of this game. If Chong Yihan is able to sustain Liu Darren and to contain him, he could very well win this game.
I think the same spot. Soft touch. It's not accurate enough from Liu Darren.
And this is what you tend players tend to do when they're tired. They try to go for quick winners. That compromises accuracy.
Good hand play.
Sometimes it works, and indeed that occasion it did for Liu Darren.
That's a fast one.
I do know that Liu Darren does service struggle with fitness. Today he's looking even more challenged physically than usual, Liu Darren.
Yet again, body language looks like Liu Darren are a little bit too relaxed. And Yihan has opened up his shoulder, much more confidence after winning the second and the third game. But bear in mind, Liu Darren has not been beaten by anyone yet. Last five matches.
Indeed, he's unbeaten this season, Liu Darren. I have to say that the last two matches we saw Liu Darren play around here, he raced to a 2-0 lead in terms of games and then let his opponents catch up and draw level 2-2.
Awal beliau bergerak ke bagian belakang.
That's a good tactical play from both of them.
Liu Darren dari Yihan.
He's ready at the front.
Pas itu
just
sangat baik.
It's good enough.
He's got height to back him up, Liu Darren. At 1.78 meters, he's able to easily reach out for that shot.
Setelah kesempatan diambil oleh Liu Darren.
So far, 21 errors from Liu Darren and 13 from Yihan. Service fault.
Service fault.
3 from Yihan.
Tertera 3 untuk Yihan. 6-4. 7-4. Keluar. Mudah untuk Liu Darren. Well, and this is where exactly I said if Chong Yihan was able to contain Liu Darren earlier on, he could have won it. But now I suspect Liu Darren is getting what we call second win. Memperkemaskan corak permainan. Dalam misi untuk mematikan pergerakan.
8-4.
And the spring in the step is coming back into Liu Darren. 8-4. Senses he could steal this game from Chong Yihan as the clock runs down to just about 2 minutes left.
Sensova. 5-8.
Drop yang cuba dilakukan oleh Liu Darren.
Puchong United right now is the winning team.
Tiga mata untuk menyamakan kedudukan.
Straight five.
Tiga mata diperlukan lawan
matches
untuk menamatkan saja.
So I'm not sure whether in that situation if Darren could feel the pressure or the big responsibility or just either way.
Follow up yang sangat baik dari Yihan.
Yeah, I suspect it's more to the second one, complacency. They know they're just 12 points away from ending this first phase of the Samsung Sen Heng Purple League on top of the table. Perhaps a little bit complacency.
Oh, ruang kosong. Nice one.
Seven.
Couldn't go to the right side. Lee Darren got a little bit trapped in the middle of the court.
It was an energy zapping rally with Chong Yihan shots. Backhand side of Liu Darren repeatedly.
7. Oh, sayang.
So Sova, 9-7.
Walaupun sudah dapat ruang.
Chong Yihan did something really smart there. He realized he's struggling with fitness. He got down on his knee as that rally ended, forcing the court to get a little bit of a mop down and time perhaps to recuperate.
Thank you. Darren,
to badminton fans at home, SS Super League in Sports Arena Sentosa.
Melawan anda, ini perlawanan pertama membabitkan pertemuan di antara Cheras BC dan juga Puchong United.
First match, Liu Darren against Chong
Yihan. Perlawanan yang keenam kekal dengan rekod kemenangan 100%.
Well, it seems like the unbeaten
wants desperately to remain unbeatable. Liu Darren. Satu mata saja lagi diperlukan Liu Darren.
Oh, that's a quick one.
Serisova.
Not even in 3 seconds. Point number 8 for Yihan.
Liu Darren has been flicking the serve to the back of the court repeatedly, and Chong Yihan caught him off guard this time.
Servis dari Chong Yihan.
Oh, what dive.
Lepas.
That's
10.
Really hard work from both players.
Well, indeed, if there's one player who can make a comeback, it has to be Chong Yihan. Remember that first game, 6-10 down for drawing level at 10-all. He might very well do it again. 23-year-old.
Thank you.
Masing-masing cuba untuk menenangkan.
13 seconds more.
Emosi menenangkan segalanya.
Each match has maximum
satu mata untuk Liu Darren menamatkan saingan.
Very interesting
satu mata untuk Chong Yihan menyamakan kedudukan. Sekaligus the memungkinkan
down to the final minute, it will only run during the rallies.
Ini set yang keempat.
Stop the 13 seconds.
Set yang kelima. Kerana hanya 13 saat masa yang tinggal. Servis penting dari Chong Yihan.
It's 2-all for Cheras and also Puchong United. What a great match to start with.
Puchong United.
Well, we expected Liu Darren to go down in this one, especially with the clock running out. But once again, he's unbeaten for a reason, Liu Darren. When it mattered most, he's able to put in all the right tactics to just sneak a draw here by the skin of his teeth, Liu Darren.
11-10, 10-11, 8-11, 11-9, 30 minutes. 2 points for Puchong United and 2 for Cheras. I think it's a brave effort from Cheras against a club who has not been beaten yet in 5 matches.
terganggu sedikit corak permainan beliau.
Puchong have only lost maximum of 3 points per tie. Except for the match against Kepong BC, but this is a great result for Chiang Yihan. He will celebrate this very much. Very close. He must feel disappointed in the end because Liu Darren beat him tactically, just slowed the game once again down in the final moments of this one. And Chiang Yihan bit the bait of Liu Darren to wildly attack and get caught on the counter attack.
Okay,
if we look at some of the final points played, we see that both players, of course, were exhausted, stepping out wearing thin, both sides on the court. But in the end, the tactically superior Liu Darren met him in the next match when it matters most. Great win, it's a great draw for Liu Darren, who very much looked like defeated.
We're going to look at the replay,
and we're going to see Liu Darren here out of position here, trying to outmaneuver his opponents. Chiang Yihan attacking here, but this is where Liu Darren catches him with that delicate little counter attacking shot off guard when Chiang Yihan's body momentum is pushing him backwards. Yet another opportunity to see attacking play of Liu Darren. This is when Chiang Yihan returned the favor to him. Both players, really incredible tactic.
Mereka lebih kurang boleh katakan agak seimbang. Kita tengok unforced error yang dilakukan oleh Liu Darren. 23
statistic, you see the unforced errors of Liu Darren. 23-17.
Okay, kita akan berat seketika. Deng Xuan akan berdepan dengan Chua Huizen.
Well, what a great match. Don't go anywhere after this. Women singles Deng Xuan against Grace Chuan. Welcome back to Sports Arena Sentosa for Purple League 2017-2018. Puchong United against Cheras BC.
Lawanan baru saja selesai sebentar tadi dalam acara persoalan lelaki.
Started with a good match, Liu Darren against Chiang Yihan.
Liu Darren dan juga Chiang Yihan yang berkesudahan seri. Dua sama.
I think that's a good opening match, Sam. What do you think?
Kedudukan agak seimbang oleh
a good opening match for Cheras BC. They certainly weren't expected to steal 2 points from Liu Darren.
Ini kita akan saksikan perlawanan
dengan pasangan
wanita.
Women singles Grace Chua Huizen, 96 in the world from Singapore.
And for Pochong United,
today she'll be playing a player from China, Deng Xuan. So clubs are actually importing great players from different countries. India, Thailand, China, and I think it's a great platform for badminton, not just for local players, but for players from all over the world.
Deng Xuan in particular is really an interesting pick for Puchong United. Remember, of course, the very last time Deng Xuan played in the Samsung Senheng Purple League, it was in February this year, in the finals of the